I came to Miami because it had a graduate program in chemistry, so my background is in biochemistry. Miami places an emphasis on undergraduate education first, but it's got the infrastructure here to do scholarship and to do research.
I had a high school teacher that was really influential. We learned about biochemistry in his class, and I participated in the Science Olympiad. I found Dr. Page's lab, and he did a lot of biochem research, particularly with proteins.
In high school, I really liked chemistry. It was one of my favorite courses, and I just found it really interesting the way that it kind of all connects with the human body.
The main goal of this research project is to develop drugs that will deactivate metallo-beta-lactamases. They're proteins that bacteria produce, and those proteins break down antibiotics. So what we're looking to do is develop drugs that target those proteins and deactivate them.
We're adding polymers onto proteins to see how we can stabilize them with different polymers, and the main goal is to eventually add the polymers to cellulase, which breaks down cellulose into glucose, which is then used for biofuels.
Current biofuels are made by taking sugars from things like corn, other crops, taking the part that you eat of the corn, using those sugars and feeding those to the yeast.
The end goal is to get a more stable cellulase, which can then be used for mass production and industry, and hopefully bring down that cost of producing the biofuels.
Trying to take the cellulose, I said corn stalks, grasses, wood chips, discarded cellulose that we typically would not use, take that and repurpose that and actually turn that into biofuels that you can put in your car.
By working with a faculty member, the student then typically takes on a project related to that faculty member's research and scholarship.
In a classroom, you learn very cut and dry procedures for solving problems, but in research, it forces you to think more in depth.
It's that ability to develop a hypothesis, see what the problem is, and then design experiments to test that hypothesis, collect data, and then analyze that data to see how it relates to what the problem that we're trying to solve.
Today I'm going to be running an activity assay to assess the activity of the cellulase that we've grown up and added the polymers to, and then I'll use our plate reader to assess the various levels of activity of each sample.
And we're going to determine whether or not it's active, right? We've made some modifications to it, we've changed it in some way. Has that made it better? Has it made it worse, or is the activity remaining the same?
Working in Dr. Page's lab has forced me to learn the skills that someone wouldn't learn until they get into graduate school.
I've been trained on a lot of different instruments that a lot of undergrads don't get to see, and you see usually more in the graduate level. We have a lot of nice equipment that once you're trained on, you really get to just kind of go for and use it on your own.
They learn all the techniques. They're able to go off and go to medical school. They can go to graduate school. But again, they can do just about anything.
I'm being offered a position at Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory in California. I'll be working at the Advanced Light Source Synchrotron, which is basically a particle accelerator, and we'll be doing X-ray crystallography.
I'm going to be attending the University of Cincinnati Medical School, where I'll get my MD degree.
I wouldn't have been offered that position without doing research with Dr. Page.